Are you a Lumix GH5 user who's thinking of switching over to the brand new full-frame Lumix S5 camera? Well, that's what I recently did, and in today's video, I'm going to be going over the pros, the cons, some first impressions, and basically giving you a mini review and finding out, is it the right decision to make? Before we get started with today's review, my name is Ben. I love to shoot wedding videos, I shoot a lot of corporate work, and I also like to take photos and videos of my family at home. On this channel, I produce lots of reviews of cameras and lenses, lots of practical tips and tricks videos, so make sure you click that subscribe button to stay up to date with all of my latest free content. So to give you a bit of background, I started filming weddings back in 2014, and at the time I was using the Canon 550D, the 600D. They were basically crop sensor Canon cameras. However, they didn't perform very well in low light, so I switched over to the Canon 5D Mark II. This camera produced a more cinematic image and it performed better in low light. However, its video features were lacking, so in 2017 I switched over to the Lumix GH5. I was over the moon. It was a small lightweight system, and it also had a feature called IBIS that let me shoot handheld. Well, if I was so happy with the GH5, why am I now switching to this, the Lumix S5? One of the main reasons is that because it's a full frame sensor, I can more easily get a cinematic look. And on top of that, the bigger sensor will help me get much cleaner results when shooting in low light. I wanted to have a single unified camera system for both photography and video. Up until now, I'd been using the GH5 for all my video productions. However, for photography, I still preferred the look I got out of my 5D Mark II. The next reason I switched over is because the Lumix S5 is the same size and weight as the GH5. And finally, price. The Lumix S5 was already a very competitively priced camera. However, right now in the UK, you can save £400 when you trade in an existing camera body. If that's something you might be interested in, I will post a link in the description below. But be quick, because that offer will end soon. My first impressions as soon as the Lumix S5 arrived is that it feels a good, solid camera body. Feels like it's going to take a lot of the knocks and bumps that are inevitable when I'm filming weddings. Also, it feels very comfortable. The button layout is going to feel very familiar if you're coming from the GH5. Everything's where you expect it to be. So let's move on to some of the advantages of the S5. The big one is that full frame sensor. It means that you can get incredible cinematic results. You can film somebody and have the background really blurred behind them, and the foreground elements really draws your attention onto the person or the object that you're filming. Secondly, that big sensor means you get much, much, much better low light performance. When I've been filming on the GH5 with its micro four thirds sensor, I can go up to about ISO 800. However, with the S5, I've been filming up to ISO 12,800. So you're able to get much brighter results in low light. Another big advantage of the Lumix S5 is the huge range of lenses that are available. First of all, you've got native lenses. As it's part of an L-mount alliance, you're going to get lenses from Panasonic, from Sigma, and from Leica. And the great thing is, between those three manufacturers, you can buy lenses that cover all sorts of budgets, all sorts of quality levels. On top of that, you can attach adapters. I actually got a Sigma adapter with the camera that allows me to attach Canon EF lenses. It has an APS-C crop mode. It's brilliant for somebody like me who likes to shoot with prime lenses, because you get so much extra versatility from having two focal lengths out of a single lens. Another advantage for GH5 users is that the video autofocus has been massively improved. If you shoot under the right conditions, specifically if you're shooting with Panasonic lenses, if you're shooting in 4K 50 or 60p or 1080 50 or 60, you're going to get some really nice results. And on top of all the advantages I've mentioned so far, it does share some of the great benefits of the GH5. That includes 4K 60, incredible IBIS. This allows you to shoot some really nice footage handheld without always needing a monopod or a tripod. unlimited recording times for all video modes up to 4K 25p 8-bit. You can shoot slow motion footage in 4K or super slow motion footage in 1080. An articulated screen. Internal 10-bit video recording. The camera is highly customizable, so you can pick out your particular favorite video features and attach them to buttons that you can easily access. There are audio inputs. There's dual card slots. This is incredible, especially if you're an event shooter, as you can have a backup recording. Long life batteries, so you don't need to take lots with you to get through a full day of shooting. There's lots of focus and exposure assist features to help you get the absolute best footage possible. And finally, the price. I feel that the Lumix S5 is very competitively priced when you consider all of the incredible video features that you're getting. As I mentioned earlier, you will find links in the description below if you are interested in purchasing the camera. So, moving on to some of the disadvantages of the camera, the EVF has a lower resolution compared with that of the GH5. Whilst you can tell it's not quite as crisp and clear, it is still plenty good enough to use and to make sure that you're hitting focus with every shot. The full-size HDMI port from the GH5 has been changed for a micro HDMI port on the S5. It does feel a little bit more flimsy in the camera. While the camera is the same size and weight as the GH5, the lenses do tend to be a lot bigger and heavier because it's part of a full frame system. This is even more so if you're wanting to use the professional level lenses. However, it's a sacrifice I'm willing to make to get that lovely full frame footage. If you are using 4K 50 or 60 on this camera, it will enforce an APS-C crop. I feel it's a little bit of an inconvenience, but I do think it's something that you can get used to and you can work with. And finally, video autofocus. While it has come on in leaps and bounds compared with the GH5, and from my initial tests, I do think it will be usable in most shooting conditions, I do have to bear in mind that it is still behind Canon and Sony. So let's sum things up now. Am I happy I made the switch to the S5 from the GH5? It has to be a definite yes from me. To have a camera body that is the same small size and weight as the GH5, but with a full frame sensor, is just phenomenal. It means that moving forwards, I can get even more cinematic results and even better low light performance. Two things that are very important when I'm going to be filming weddings. Additionally, it's great to know that I have a camera system now that I can use for my photography as well and get lovely results, and that I can share those beautiful lenses that I buy for both purposes, photography and video. And secondly, do I think that you should switch over to the Lumix S5 too? Well, it depends. If you're currently on the GH5 and you're happy with the results you're getting, and if you're also wanting a camera system where the not just the camera but also the lenses are as small and lightweight as they could possibly be, well, the GH5 takes some beating in that respect. However, if you are looking for a new camera where you can get the absolute most cinematic results possible, beautiful dynamic range, beautiful colours, incredible depth of field, and also phenomenal low light performance, well, in that respect, the S5 is an absolute winner and it should definitely be up for your consideration. Well, what do you think about the S5? Have you already made the switch? Are you thinking about doing so? What are you excited about the camera, or what are you concerned about? Any questions or comments you have, please pop them down in the comment section below. Also, if you've not subscribed, please do so, as I'm going to have lots more videos soon about this camera and all the lenses that go with it. If you are considering buying it, don't forget those links are in the description below. And also, give us a like, give us a share, and I'll see you next time.